Hi, I'm Alex, and this is the iPhone 5S. It is the 2013 entrant for Apple's iPhone range. It's the upgraded version of the iPhone 5, as you might guess from the name. And also, as you might guess from the name, in terms of design, it's pretty much exactly the same as the iPhone 5, the original one. It is a little bit different in terms of color scheme. So instead of black, they've gone with what they're calling space gray, which is this sort of graphite look you've got on the back here instead of just a uniform black the whole way down. They've also released a gold, or what they call champagne version, and then you've got the normal white one. But in terms of just size, shape, design, everything other than color, really, this is just exactly the same. So as far as hardware goes, on the iPhone 5S, you've got the A7 processing chip, 1 gig of RAM, which still does the job because Apple gets to design everything around using that 1 gig of RAM. And you've got three storage options. So you've got the 16 gigabyte, 32 gigabyte, and 64 gigabyte options, all onboard storage. They don't actually use a micro SD in this, so you don't have anything expandable. But 64 gig is really as much as you're ever gonna need on a phone anyway. Being an iPhone, obviously it's going to have a fantastic camera. This absolutely does. Strangely enough, it's not the best camera on the market anymore. Apple has held that title ever since the first iPhone came out. Still absolutely fantastic, but because companies like Nokia are starting to make things like the 1020, which is a very camera-specific phone, it has been outshined a little bit. We took this out, we gave it a test in some low light conditions, and it was very impressive. It did really admirably, just keeping the color balance, not letting too much light bleeding come in. Very impressive, very good. Now, the most notable thing that everyone knows about the iPhone 5S is that it has this fingerprint scanner down here where the home button is. This isn't the first phone that has had a fingerprint scanner put in it. There was a few Android phones that came before it. But Apple are the first people to really do it well. It works pretty much every time you go to use it, but what Apple's done with the integration is quite clever. So instead of just being a security thing that you unlock your phone, you can also use it to purchase apps, which makes things much easier. All that being said, there is one major complaint with the iPhone 5S that Apple is going to have to deal with sooner or later, and that is the screen size. They have recently upgraded with the iPhone 5. They went from 3.5 to 4 inches, finally. But it's still just not big enough. You hear it from people online, you hear it from people you talk to. The main thing iPhone 5S users want, or iPhone users want, is a bigger screen. They see their Android friends with the bigger screens, their Windows phones friends with the bigger screen, and they're starting to get envious. And it's something that Apple really needs to play catch up on quite desperately here. And the reason they're not feels more like stubbornness than anything, because they've been saying that 3.5 is the perfect screen size for so long, and now they're saying that 4 is the perfect screen size. They've sort of backed themselves into a corner, and I think they just need to bite the bullet. Give us a 4.5 or even 5-inch screen with the next iPhone, or they're gonna start risking losing people, I think, to the Android ecosystem. So yeah, great device. Pretty much the same as what came before, but a bit upgraded. Obviously, you've got iOS 7 in there now, which has brought a couple of extra things, like the drag-up control panel from the bottom. And you've still got absolutely one of the best cameras on the market. So, well done, Apple. Yes, this is a good handset. Just let's try and get something a little bit more new next time, please.